This is the funerary relief of Attia Rufilla. It's an upright stone slab made of marble that offers a portrait of the deceased. We know its date is about mid-first century CE or AD to the reign of Nero. There's an architectural framework, a triangular pediment, perhaps flattened columns there on either side. On the upper molding, we have her name, Attia Rufilla. And the most important is the portrait in relief, carved so that it juts out from the stone background. She looks like a woman, we would say, of middle age or older, with lines, right? Frown lines around the mouth, jaw, worry lines under the eyes, nose somewhat strong, a protruding brow, severe features, right? Not an image that would project her as younger, right? More glamorous. However, the inscription contradicts that because in between her name, Attia Rufilla, it says M.F., which it's daughter of Marcus. Any Roman woman would be married by this time, at least by the age of 18 or 20. Young girls who die before they are married have their father's name on their tombstone. So it's interesting that she is not married and her face shows marks of age. So I'm drawn to it because it's an artwork in which we know the purpose to create a memory for this woman, to commemorate her life, her looks, her face. And we know that the stone has succeeded, right? It has created a memory for her. We visit her in the lobe, and I'm talking about her now, Attia Rufilla.